So here we are again, and now we are ready to speak about the little bit about the meditations of the Leila Seder. Okay, what is the meaning of the wine and the matzot? First of all, right? All the other things are minor. The main things on Leila Seder is the wine, 4 cups, and the 4 kazait of matzah. Yeah, how does it work? We have the 4 cups is the mochin of bina, abundance that comes from the left side. This is called bina, ima. Okay, when we get into the matzot, that will be the mind of chochma, which is related with abba, patuf abba. Okay, if you don't know those concepts, so I'm not gonna like try to explain all of that right now. There is a book about it, the introduction of the Sidur Zichron David. It's also on the website as Kabbalah meditation, Jewish meditation from scratch. So whoever is interested can look there about what is Abba, Ima, and Mochin. Anyhow, Mochin is like literally it means brain. But when we speak about it in the Kabbalah, it means abundance that comes down to the brain. But not our brain, about like the spiritual brain of the Potsufim. So we have 4 parts within each one of those. Okay, we have the mochin of Abba, mochin of Ima, and each one of those splits to 4. What are the 4? So that's why we have 4 fingers. Yeah, besides of the 5th one, 4 fingers. So we have chochma, bina, chasadim, and gevurot. Okay, chochma, bina, chasadim, and gevurot. Okay, so according to that, it's very simple. That's the 1st cup, 2nd cup, 3rd cup, 4th cup. Yeah. So you have 4 cups for the Chochma of Ima, Bina of Ima, Chasadim of Ima, Gevurot of Ima. The Chasadim and Gevurot are together at the dot. Okay? So the 1st cup is the Chochma of Ima, 2nd cup, Bina of Ima, 3rd and 4th cup is the dot, which is the Chasadim and Gevurot of the dot. All of that is Mochin of Ima. Okay? Very nice. Same thing is with the Matzah, Mochin of Abba, right? So we have 4 kazaitim. Where is there 4 kazaitim? So, Amotzi lechem min ha'aretz, and al achilat matzah, right? That's the beginning of eating the matzah, right? So, there we have 2 brachot, 2 kazaitim. So we have the Chochma of Abba, Bina of Abba, right? Then we have Korech, it's another kazait, when we're eating the Korech. And when we get to the Fikoman, that's the 4th kazait. Okay? So the Korech is the Chasadim of the Dad, and the Fikoman is the Gevurot of the Dad. Right? So 4 kazaitim equals to the 4 cups. Very good, very nice. That's the basic foundation of those meditations of the Leila Seder. Now, if you got that clear in your mind, so then we can go to the next step. Okay? Are you ready for the next step? Or I give you some digesting time with all of the wine and the matzot. Maybe you need some time before we go into the next course. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Can I go to the next course?
Yes. Great.
Okay, I'm going to the next course. So, to make it that it will be a little bit more interesting, so the Arizal explained that there is levels of growth, okay? Levels of growth. All year long, we're starting with a certain level of mochin, and we climb up the ladder, right? We're getting like another step. Every step we take, we're getting a new level of mochin. Good. Now, what happens in Pesach? In Pesach, we have a miracle. What is the miracle of Pesach? Yitziat Mitzrayim. It means, spiritual wise, besides of the physical manifestation of that, but the spiritual aspect of the Yitziat Mitzrayim, it means that all of a sudden, in one shot, in one night, what takes usually like a long time, climb up so fast, no one can stop us. Yeah, the Egyptians are trying to run after us, but Hashem is pushing us forward, so we're getting away. Okay, that's basically the the understanding. Now, what does it mean meditation-wise? That we have a lot of work, right? What usually takes like a work that of bringing down mochin, it takes like a long period of time, so it splits to many, many prayers, and like we have, you know, a lot of opportunities to do like each thing in a time. Now, like we have to do it very fast, okay? So because we have to do it very fast, one of the applications of that is that you have to organize your mind, in your mind, what you're going to do. Yeah, you have to know from advance, like all that, like structure of how it works, and to, in Yiddish they call it hold the cup, to hold your mind and not to be distracted by different things. And obviously, whenever is something important, a big opportunity that comes up, so the Yetzirah is usually trying to steal out the opportunity. So prepare yourself to that it will be all kinds of obstacles and people that are trying to speak with you and take you to different subject matters and all kinds of different things. But if you want to gain the potential of that night, you have to be focused. Okay, you have to be focused and remember what is it that you need to do and to be there and meditate on each thing at the right time. And then you can gain all of this potential, okay? But it's a challenge, you know, because it's important, so it's a challenge. Anyhow, after all of this introduction, what is the setup? What is the structure of the mochin? So I'm saying now, I'm not expecting you that you will remember, that it's called katnut vegadlut aleph, katnut vegadlut bet. Okay, there's four levels. Again, I'm going from the bottom. Katnut vegadlut aleph. The two bottom ones is aleph. Katnut, gadlut, aleph. The minority and the majority, A. And then we have katnut, gadlut, bet. The minority and majority, B. Okay? What's the difference between A and B? A is, in the Kabbalah, we call that yasud, bina. Okay, I'm not going to like make it too complicated. I'm trying to keep it simple. So forget about your suit now. This is the lower level. Okay, the A is the lower level. The B is the higher level. Let's just be happy with that.
Chochma? Or don't even say that.
Both of them have bina and chochma inside of them. Anyhow, bottom line, usually we go 1, 2, 3, 4. We go in the order. But in Leila Seder, the reader says, no, don't do that. Why? Because this first level, that is like the minority of the first level of the mochin, is very sensitive. It's like a baby, fragile, soft. Can't put it like, you know, first, because the Egyptians are out there, right? The negative forces are out there. So we don't want to let them grab anything. So we put the kids in the back, yeah? We put the minority A in the back. So we're doing we're stepping over it, okay? We're jumping over it, and we're going to the majority of A. The majority of A says, the Arizal, you don't have to worry about it. That's a present. Hashem gives it to Am Yisrael. This is the holiness of the Yom Tov. Okay? So we have the majority A. So now we have to work on the minority and majority of B. That's our work, okay? So how does it come? The minority of B comes with the act. For example, pouring the cup and holding the cup, that will be the minority of B. And then when we're saying the words of the Kiddush, we're bringing the majority of B. So we got all those four levels in our hand when we're doing the Kiddush, okay? Not exactly. We put the minority A, we put it aside, so we'll go back to it. That will be in the karpas when we're eating the celery. But for now, we did as much as we can. That was the first cup. Okay, so again, what is the first cup? It is mochin of Ima. It is the chochma of Ima. And inside of chochma of Ima, we have those four levels. Minority A we put aside. Majority A, Hashem is giving us to us as a present. The minority B comes with the physical act of holding the cup, and the majority B comes with the Kiddush itself. Good. Going down to the celery. Yeah? Going down to the celery. The karpas. Karpas is the minority A that we put aside. So it comes in now. So what's the difference? What change? We said it's sensitive. It's a look. So the Arizal explains that after we did the kiddush, so we already gained so much light, so we can bring on the children. There's no harm. Okay.
You say bring on the children. You mean
the minority? The minority A that we put aside, that we said it is sensitive. Yeah. We can apply that and we can bring those mochin. So that comes with the karpas, celery, yeah? When you dip it in the salty water, you say Borei Pri Adama, in that bracha, you made it on the minority A, okay? If you have like sidur like that, this one or different one, so there is like all kinds of names to manifest in the letters of the holy names, how those mochin are coming down, okay? But if not, so at least to have the abstract understanding of that is also meaningful, okay? So if you think about those concepts in those different times, every time each thing it in its time, it's also very significant, okay? And that will be, B'zrat Hashem, good preparation for next year. That next year we won't need to do anything because Mashiach will do all the work for us. Maybe. I don't know how it works with Mashiach around. If we have to do Kavanot, we don't have to do Kavanot, we'll leave it to him. Whatever he will say, we'll do. But, whoever is able to do the extra meditations with the holy names, definitely it will be even much more significant and bringing on extra abundance and mochin and mercy for Am Yisrael, for the whole world, and so on and so forth. Good. So we got to the kazait of matzah, right? We got to the matzah. Fine. So we said that we have two kazaitim of amotzi lechem min haaretz en asher kidshenu tzitav tzivanu al achilat matzah for the chochma and bina from the side of Abba. Okay. Now, what about those mochin? Do we have the same logic that we're putting out aside the minority A? So that's a whole discussion about it. I'm not going to drag you into that discussion now. But bottom line, you can have in mind that you have those four levels of mochin, okay? Minority, majority A, minority, majority B, and as much as you can, bring all of that while you're doing the matzah. You have a lot of time. Right, it takes a long time to do the matzah well enough. So while you're doing that, try to think about those concepts. Fine, very good. Now, after you ate the matzah or the two kazaitim matzah, you get to the korech. I said the maror. The secret of the maror, the meditation of the maror, is that maror is to remove death. Okay? Maror is the gematria of sar mavet. Sar mavet, to remove death. So when you're doing the maror well, you're meditating that the maror is the judgments, and by doing on the maror, you are sweetening the judgments. Okay? That's a very applicable meditation, specifically in this time. So
that's why you want to chew it so well.
So that's why I said to chew it well. Yes, that's exactly. Fine. So also, the same letters of Sar Mavet is also the gematria of Rut, Sach. Okay, Rut is a certain manifestation of the feminine partzuf, nukba, and the sach, the samechet, is gematria of ekeye avaya ekeye. Ekeye is alef ke yud ke, 21, yud ke vav ke. Okay, I didn't plan to go to the names, but came out, so fine. So 21, 26, 21 all together is 68. Okay, so this 68 is the sach. So we bring basically bring those mochin to root, which is a certain aspect of the feminine partsuf. Okay, now we got to the korech. The korech, we said, is the third kazait, which is again the chasadim of Abba. Right? Again, the four levels of mochin: minority, majority, minority, majority. Fine, got that clear with the help of Hashem. Now you can eat all the rest of the food that you prepared as much as you're able. Yeah, some people, they like after eating like that, they are already like blocked. They can't eat much more, like the three kazaitim of matzah. Anyhow, usually there's a lot of food, but not much strength to eat it. So as much as you can, eat and enjoy, and then you get to the afikoman, right, basically. And the afikoman is the fourth kazait, and you made it on the gevurot of Abba. And after Birkat HaMazon, we're getting to the third cup, which is the chasadim of Ima, right? So the same idea with the chasadim of Ima, and also the fourth cup, which is the gevurot of Ima. All of that comes down with those four levels: minority, majority, minority, majority. Okay, so all of that understanding that I started with, that we're putting the minority A aside, is only in the first cup. Okay, for a conclusion, we just do it in the first cup. In the rest of the cups, the kazait of the matzot, you don't have to apply all of that meditation. You can. I'm not saying no. There is discussion about it, but me personally, I don't do that. Anyhow.
Just in the kiddush is enough.
Yeah, after, as far as I'm concerned, we did the first kiddush. That's it. We canceled the negativity. We canceled the Egyptians, and they are, you know, now they're ready to convert. They want to convert. They want to join the Seder. You don't have to push them aside. I'm not sure about this one, but we'll keep it for another discussion. Okay, fine. So basically, that's the basic meditations for Leila Seder. Obviously, there's much more. when you're saying the Nirtzeh in the end of the Seder, so there is understanding that is another discussion, and this understanding is that Nirtzeh is equal to Sim Shalom that we spoke about yesterday in the Zichron David class. So that's unity. Okay. So basically, to bring all of what we did to unity, so that's the Nirtzeh. But practically, to say the truth, it's not brought down in the Rashash, brought down in the Sidur Rashash, the students of the Rashash. So my Rabbi Chai said not to do that, but there is like a certain beauty to add that meditation in the end of the Seder to have it something completed. Truth of the matter is that the unity of Leila Seder, the end of Leila Seder, is only when you get to the day meal of Shavuot. Okay, another 51 days from then. But that will be another discussion when we'll get closer to Shavuot. We'll speak about Shavuot with the help of Hashem. We'll all be here healthy and strong with many, many more other people. For the meantime, we'll hold it here.
What about Baruch
Halel. Adonai Leolam?
Halel.
Halel.
We say halal in after the seuda, or
we okay. So I will tell you, there is everybody are saying the halal before and after the Birkat HaMazon. Mm-hmm. Okay, half before Birkat HaMazon and half after Birkat HaMazon. The discussion is about saying halal after arvit, before the Leila Seder. According to the Sfaradim and the Hasidim, there is another halal after arvit. According to the Ashkenaz tradition, there is no other halal after arvit. Okay, so here in Diaspora Yeshiva, they don't do another Halel after Arvit. They just do the Halel after the inside of the Leila Seder, not inside of the meal. So I wanted to say, according to like a certain like explanation for the Ashkenazi custom of not saying the another extra Halel, that it says in the Rashash that the meal is the external aspect of the prayer. Okay, whatever we did in the prayer of Arvit internally, we're doing afterwards again in the Leila Seder externally. Okay, and that's a general understanding. It's not only about Pesach. Also in Shabbat, we have prayer and a meal. A prayer and a meal every time. Yeah? So every time we're doing the internal work, external work. Good. So that's fine. Now, according to that understanding, so the Halel after Arvit, to those that do that, is to say thank you Hashem for the mochin that you gave us the strength to bring down in Arvit, in the prayer. And when we're saying the Halel after the Haggadah, it is the same thing to say thank you Hashem for giving us the strength to bring those mochin of the external aspect. Okay? So, what is the logic behind not saying the Halel after the internal? That it's not completed yet. Yeah? You don't say like thank you when I'm still counting the money that I'm giving you. Yeah, let me finish. When I'm done, so then say thank you, right? So basically when you're saying the Halel after the Haggadah, so then you have in mind that it is also for the external and also for the internal. Yeah, that's what I wrote here in this book for the Ashkenazim that they don't do the Halel. Me personally, I do the Halel because that's the custom of the Rashash, the Rizal, and also the Vilna Gaon says it. So that's like usually most of the Ashkenazim, they follow the Vilna Gaon, but in that aspect, for some reason, they don't follow the Vilna Gaon. They just says in the Ramah that our custom is not to do, so many Ashkenazim don't do. But whoever does, that's, you know, very, very legit. There's definitely a lot of opinions to rely on.
If Ashkenazim have turkey for Leil Seder, do they say hodu?
That's a good question. If you bring a turkey to, so then we'll discuss it.
If I can get to a market, Bezrat Hashem, I'll bring a turkey.
Okay, fine. Bezrat Hashem. So we'll hold it here. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen v'amen.